H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing, and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.
Okay, so let me know when you are able to see my screen. I just shared my desktop, so you should be able to see my desktop now. So we'll be using chat window for the answers, so that I can quickly see that. So let me know if you are able to see my desktop. So you can respond in the chat window if you are able to see. Okay, thank you. I see one response. So let's make the class interactive. So I'll be asking questions in the middle, so that you can respond in the chat window. So that will ensure that the course is interactive, and I also feel that people are active listening to the class. So that way we can make the class more engaged and interactive class. So let me open the course content document which I have. So in case if you don't have, you can drop a mail to training at h2k infosys. They will be sharing this document with you. So let me open the course document. So before starting the course, as I already introduced in the demo class, so my name is Meghnad. So I have around 8.5 years of IT industry experience, and I have been taking online classes for the past 4 to 6 years, and I have taken numerous trainings for Australian and US students as well. So my key technical skills include HTML, CSS, JavaScript, SQL Server, C#, ADO.NET and ASP.NET. So in case if you have any doubts regarding the course content or anything related to duration or all the details, you can just call this number. Please make a note of this, 770-777-1269, or you can drop a mail to training@h2kinfosys.com. So keep note of these two contact details. And coming back, the details about myself. So I worked for companies like Accenture, Cognizant, and even I worked for Infosys for 4 years. So I have been very much passionate for conducting trainings. So I'm here. Okay, so let's get started with the course. Today we'll see a simple C# program, and we don't need any Visual Studio software for today. And after today's class, we might need Visual Studio to be installed. Okay. So, how about others? I see one message saying from Sonal saying like she's not able to hear me. How about others? You're able to hear me? You're able to hear my voice? Okay, I see response like you're able to hear. So one of the students says she's not able to hear. So give me a minute. Just a second, I'm checking with one of the student who is not able to hear. So please wait for a minute. Okay, I told her to join back the meeting. Okay, so let's get started. So today we'll see how to write a simple C# program using Notepad. We'll not be using any Visual Studio. So I'll be sending the link for installing Visual Studio after today's class. And so we'll also see what is .NET framework, and where we can see if .NET framework is installed or not, and what is the use of .NET framework, and what is Visual Studio, and why we need to go for .NET instead of other technologies. And also we'll see what is .NET framework class library, and what is CLR, CTS, MSIL, JIT explanation. So all these things we are going to see some of the concepts today, and some of the concepts we'll see tomorrow. So let's get started. So first thing what I want to verify is, let's verify whether we have .NET framework installed in our computer or not. So .NET framework comes with your VoIS operating system. So I hope all of you are having Windows 7 or Windows 8. So anyone is having Windows XP, can you please ping me what is the OS you have? What is the operating system you have? Just I want to see from all the attendees, like what is the operating system you're using? So I got one response, Windows 8. So I got couple of responses. So please ping me what Windows, which version? Windows 7 or Windows 8 or Windows XP or okay. Okay, great. So I see all of you having Windows 7 or Windows 8. So I see all of you are having Windows 7 or Windows 8. So that should do. So now let's verify whether we have .NET framework installed or not. To verify that, all of you need to go to My Computer. So I'll just tell the path where you need to verify. So you have to tell me whether. So I'm not seeing the response from few attendees. So please respond to me so that I'll understand that you guys are also practicing what I'm saying. So what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to see whether .NET framework is installed or not. So remember, there is difference between Visual Studio and the .NET framework. So both are not same. .NET framework which comes with the operating system, whereas Visual Studio is a software which is used for working on .NET. So without using Visual Studio also, you can write C# programs and you can compile them. So today we are going to see how to do that without using Visual Studio. So let me verify whether we have .NET framework installed or not. So .NET framework, I'm asking about .NET framework, not Visual Studio. So I need to go to C colon and then I need to go to Windows folder and I need to verify in Microsoft.net. Inside that I'll be seeing framework and framework 64. So if your computer is 64 bit, you might need to look into this framework 64, otherwise you might need to look into framework. So can all of you verify whether you have .NET framework in this folder? What is the maximum number you have? So I have .NET framework 4.0 installed in my computer. So can all of you verify in this path? C: Windows Microsoft.net framework. Inside this, I want the response from all of you, which is the latest folder you have, whether do you have 3.0 or do you have 4.0 v4.0, what is the late, so you need to ping me v4.0 if you have this folder v4.0. so yeah, I got one response. I need the response like v4.0 if you have this folder. I got three responses. So all of you please go to this path. This is the path where you can see that the .NET framework is installed or not. So the path is C: Windows Microsoft.net v4.0 under framework 64. Yeah, that's great. So you need to go to this path, C: Windows Microsoft.net framework. So if someone asks you whether can you please see whether .NET framework is installed or not, all you need to do is you need to go to this path, C: Windows Microsoft.net framework. And the other way to do that is you can verify in programs and features, installed programs. But anyway, let's for now. I'm sorry. Yeah. So the difference between framework and framework 64 folders is that so normally if you have 64-bit Windows operating system, so you need to look into framework 64, and if you have normal 32-bit operating system, you need to look into framework folder. So framework 64 is specifically for 64-bit framework. Okay. So now I'm just going to Microsoft.net framework and version 4.0. So this one will work both in 32-bit as well as 64-bit. But if you go to version framework 64 and version 4.0, that will only work in framework 64. Okay. So now I have selected Windows, Microsoft.net framework and version 4.0. So now anyone not having this version 4.0, can you please ping me like you don't have? So I see the response from all of you that 4.0 has been there. So that's great. So now what we will do is, all of you please open command prompt, Windows R CMD. I hope all of you know how to open command prompt. So C colon users, you can open command prompt and then just type CSC. So when you type CSC, CSC is the compiler for C# programming. So CSC is the compiler for C# programming. So can you please type CSC and see whether what is the output you are getting? I guess most of you will be getting the output as not recognized command. Can you please try that and tell me, what are you getting the same response like this, or are you getting not recognized command? So the moment you type CSC, for me I'm getting like so I'm getting like Visual C# compiler version 4.0, something like this. But for you, you will be getting as not recognized as internal or external command, right? So now if you want to make sure that, can you please again go to this folder? So go to this folder, Microsoft Framework version 4.0, and inside this folder you will see something called CSC. So can you please see whether you have this CSC inside this folder? So just type CSC, it'll take you for that folder, csc.exe or CSC. So you will see the size of the file is 1769. So I repeat again, just a second. So go to this folder, C: Windows Microsoft .NET Framework version 4.0, and then go to this folder, verify that you have this file csc.exe or not. So I'm sure all of you will be having the csc.exe. The size can differ, but yeah. So if you have this csc.exe, all you need to do is copy this path. So C: Windows Microsoft .NET Framework version 4.0. Copy this path. Please listen to me, and then after that you can try this. Copy this path, and then what you need to do is, So I'll explain this again. So copy the path version 4.0. Copy this complete path. Right click and copy up to version 4.0. So once you copy this, I'll repeat again, don't worry if you're not able to follow this step. I'll repeat again. Copy the folder path and then right click on my computer and then properties. Go to advanced system settings, and then I repeat again, for now please listen to me, environment variables, and then if you go down little bit you will see something called path. You will see path here and click on edit. At the end of this, what you need to do is you need to paste it. Right click, paste whatever the path you copied, and then click on OK. I repeat again, please don't do it. I'll explain three times, so I'm going to explain second time now. So copy the path where framework version 4.0. Just a second. One of the students is asking me a question. So okay, so now I'm repeating for the second time. So yes, one of the attendees says like she's able to see only CSC and not the exe. So if you want to see the extensions, what you need to do is you have to go to organize. By default you will not see the extension. So if you see here, for example, so this is called file name and this is called after dot whatever you see, this is called extension. So this is the file name and this is the extension. So now by default you will not be seeing the extension. What you need to do is, if you want to see the extension, what you need to do is you need to click on organize and then go to folder and search options. If you want to see the extensions of the files, what you need to do is you need to go to organize, folder and search options. Maybe for Windows 8 you might not be able to see this option, but for Windows 7 people they can do this if you want to see the extension. So click on organize, folder and search options, and then go to view, and you need to uncheck this option, hide the extensions for known file types. Hide the extensions for known file types. You need to uncheck this. By default this will be checked for you, so you need to uncheck this option. The moment you uncheck this option and click on OK, and then you will be able to see the extensions like csc.exe. See, now for example, if I go here and folder and search options, if I go to view, if I check this option, now I am checking this option. If I check this option, click on apply OK. Now I am not seeing the extensions. See here, I'm only seeing CSC for this. So even though this is I'm seeing this as csc.exe, but this is not the csc.exe file. This is csc.exe.config file. So if I want to see the extensions for all the files, what I need to do is I need to go to organize, I need to click on organize, I need to click on folder and search options, and I need to go to view, and I need to uncheck this option. I need to remove this option. So let me uncheck this option. Apply. Okay. Now I'm seeing when I type CSC here, I'm able to see csc.exe, which is application file. Okay. So this is about how to enable seeing the extension for folders. So let's again go back to the topic. How do we add in application variables? So today it will be a bit confusing. Don't worry. I'll ensure that you are very clear with what we are discussing today. So I'm going to tell again how to configure the path in environment variables. So now go to this folder version 4.0, copy this path. I'm just right click on this, copy this path. Now go to start, right click on my computer, and then right click on my computer and then properties. Yes, I am recording today's class, I'm recording today's class. Okay, so just a second, one of the students says she's not able to hear me. So for the first class you might see these queries, so please bear with me from the next class. So if you don't have advanced system settings, I guess you're using Windows 7 or Windows 8. So for those who are seeing Windows 8, I guess they might not see advanced system settings, but there is a way to do that. So for them, what they can do is I'll tell one solution for them as well. Okay, for Windows 7 you don't see this, is it? Okay, so how about others? Are you able to see this? When you right click on my computer, so right click on this computer and then properties. When you click on properties, are you seeing this advanced system settings? So those who are seeing this advanced system settings, click on advanced system settings. Okay, I got only one response, like they are able to see advanced system settings. How about others? They are able to see this advanced system settings option. Yeah, I got a response from Jesse. They are able to see that. Okay, good. Only from couple of students I'm getting option like they're not able to see that. So don't worry if you're not able to see. I'll tell other way as well. So now just a second, one of the student is not able to just a second, for today, as I said, please bear with me. couple of students are having not able to hear the audio sound, so okay, so one of the students is not able to hear the audio, so please bear me for today. Tomorrow onwards we'll see this queries less, so I don't want to spend much time. Okay, so now so I'll again come back to this. So I'm copying, I repeat again, I'm copying this folder, right click on this copy, so and then again go to this, right click on my computer, properties, click on advanced system settings. If you're not able to see advanced system settings, it's okay. Well, it's okay, no problem. So now what you need to do is click on environment variables. Click on environment variables. So do it now. Do it now along with me. Click on environment variables. And then you need to click little bit down and you need to go to path. So you need to go to this path. So all of you done till here. You need to click on path. Don't do anything. So once you click on this path, others who don't have advanced system settings, it's okay, I'll tell a solution in a couple of minutes. So click on this path and click on edit and then put a semicolon at the end. If you don't have semicolon at the end, put a semicolon at the end. I repeat again, do not modify this anything, do not remove anything which is here. So be very careful. I'm repeating again. So click on advanced system settings and then click on environment variables and then go down little bit in system variables and select, click on path, click on edit. You're not able to see my screen. Attendees, you're able to see my screen? Okay. So click on edit and put a semicolon. See, I'm having a semicolon here. If you don't have semicolon at the end, put a semicolon. Please add a semicolon and then paste the path which you copied. Okay, so okay, so put a semicolon at the end and then no, I think you need to, yeah, so I repeat again, so don't copy this one. So what I'm saying is I'm not asking to paste in the chat window. So what is my question is, you need to click the path, click on edit. I already told you guys to copy the path up to version 4.0, so you would have copied this path. Whatever you copied, so I said to copy whatever you copied, you all of you go to normal framework only. Instead of framework 64, you can go for framework only, framework. So I'll wait for questions, give me a couple of minutes. So copy this version 4.0 and whatever you copied, you need to paste it after the semicolon here in this. So right click on this, you need to paste it and then click on semicolon. Okay, so I repeat again, go to this folder version 4.0. I'll be repeating this because this is very important step. Go to this folder C:\Windows-Microsoft.NET Framework version 4.0, copy this path and then paste it here after adding a semicolon with already existing one. Do not remove anything, just click on path, click on edit, add a semicolon at the last at the end, and after the semicolon, whatever you have copied the path, paste it, and then put a semicolon again. So all of you done with this step, click on OK, and click on OK, and close the parent window. So done with this step. If you are done, please tell me if it's done. Okay, I see one response like it's done. So how about others? Are you done with this step? Okay, waiting for others. I didn't get response from Jesse. Yeah, okay. So now what you need to do is, now go to command prompt. So for those who are not done, don't worry. Yeah, you need to, after you paste it, it's optional to keep the semicolon. But before pasting it, you have to keep semicolon, and after semicolon, you have to paste the path which you copied. Okay, so now go to command prompt, Windows R CMD, and then type CSC. Close your already existing command prompt. Close your command prompt and now type CSC. And for those who don't have advanced system settings, what they need to do is they need to do this. So how about other? Please tell me those who have done this step. When you type CSC, are you able to see like this? Are you able to see? Previously you are getting not recognized command. So now what you are seeing? Yeah, no input specified. So are you getting this line when you type CSC? Are you getting this line saying like Visual C Sharp compiler version 4.0? So this is what previously you would have seen, like not recognized command. So now you are able to see. So for Sonal alone, who is okay. So okay, great. So now for those who are not able to see this, okay, good. So anyone who is for whom still you are getting not recognized command, can you please ping me who is getting not recognized command when you type CSC? Please ping me if anyone is getting not recognized command when you type CSC. Okay, so I see one student who just joined. No problem. For those who have missed today's class, okay. So, just a second. One student has just joined. Okay, so just for a change, what I'll do now is I'll make one of you as presenter. Can you please explain what we have done? For those who missed it, okay, let me explain. I'll not do it now. So for those who missed it, I'm going to explain again in a minute. So all you need to do is you need to verify in C: Windows Microsoft.NET Framework version 4.0 folder. So go to this folder, copy this path, right click on this, copy this path. Once you copy this, all you need to do is copy this path. I repeat again. So C: Windows Microsoft.NET Framework version 4.0. So from tomorrow, please be on time for the class, so that I'll not spend time for repeating. Okay. So copy this path, and what you need to do is go to Start, right click on My Computer, Properties, and Advanced System Settings. Go to Advanced System Settings, right click on My Computer, Properties, click on Advanced System Settings, click on Environment Variables, and go to the variable called path, click on edit, add a semicolon at the end, and then paste the path which you copied. Click on OK. So once you do that, So once you do that, for those who are not done, don't worry, you can for today's class you will get the recording. So now after adding that, when I type CSE, it will be recognized. So now what we will do is we will try to write a simple C# program. So we'll just get started with a simple C# program. So now Windows R, I'm opening Notepad. So please listen. Even Windows 7, Windows 7 users also should be able to do it. I'll tell in a minute. So for those who are not able to see, the advanced system settings, please, I'll just explain it again. I'll just tell the solution. Okay. So now I'm going to write a simple C# program. So using system, remember C# is case sensitive. C# is case sensitive. So using system, and I'm going to write a simple, very simple C# program. So class hello, and then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to type here public static void main. Remember in C sharp M is okay. So in C sharp M is capital letter. Okay, so now what you need to do is, so for those who just joined, who missed the previous half an hour session, no problem, you can focus from now. So now I'm writing public static void main. Don't worry, what is public, what is static, what is void, and what is main, I'll explain this later. So I'm just writing you a simple structure of C# program. So using system, class hello, public static void main, and to print here in C# we have to use console.write line. Okay, so let me reduce the font size so that I can write it in the single line. I don't need to do it in multiple lines. So where is this flower brackets, on which button we have? Can someone tell me where do we have this flower brackets? So we have adjacent to letter P on the keyboard, you see this flower brackets. Okay, so now console.write line, and console.write line, I'm adding this bracket, and all I need to do is I need to write hello world. So for those who know C language, so how many of you can recollect your C programming, or how many of you know C programming, you can ping me in the chat window. So how many of you know C programming? Okay, I got one response. How many of you know C programming, normal C programming? Okay, so I got a couple of responses. Okay, so now let's try to recollect. No problem. So even if you don't know anything about programming, that's fine. So now what I will be doing is I'll write a simple C program, and then we'll compare that with C# program. So include stdio.h void main, and then we have something called here printf hello world. Okay, so this is the simple structure of C# program, and C# is not object oriented, it is structured programming language. So we will not be having, C language is not object oriented programming. C# is object oriented programming language. So the code which I have written here at the below, this is actually C programming, and we will not see anything like class, objects, anything like that in C language. So this is a header file. So why do I need to include this header file? Because my method printf, the method printf is actually present inside this header file. So that is the reason why I need to include stdio.h, because printf method is actually present inside this header file stdio.h. So what does this printf hello world will do? This will print hello world on the console window. So similar to this C program, we have I have written C sharp program here. So this is a C sharp program. So this first line is called using system is something similar to include stdio.h. So there in C language we call it as header file. In C sharp we call this as namespace. So I'll type this. So this is a namespace. System is a namespace. So we don't call here as header files or packages. In Java we call it as package. Here in C sharp we call it as namespace. We call this as namespace. So system is a namespace which is having console class. So console is a class which is actually present inside system namespace, and that is the reason why I have to write using system, because I'm using console class. Inside console class I have a method called WriteLine. WriteLine is a method which is present inside console class. So I have to write console.WriteLine. So now if someone asks you why I need to write this using system, because because your console is a class which is present inside the system namespace. So what is a namespace? Namespace is collection of classes. Or it can be even collection of namespaces. Okay, so if someone asks you again, I'm repeating again. So this is a simple structure of C sharp program. So using system, you need to include this because console is a class which is actually if you're not speaking, please keep yourself on mute. Okay, so system is a namespace which is present inside console class, and WriteLine is a method which is present. System is a namespace which contains console class. So in order to use console class, you have to include using system. Okay. So from where do we get the system? So if you again go back to your .NET folder, which is v4.0, version 4.0. If you again go back to this folder, you will be able to see system. So can all of you verify whether you have system.dll or system in your version 4.0? So the easiest way to find is start using type and then go to verify whether you have system. So go to this. So I have it here, system.dll. I have it here. Yeah, system.dll, right. So this is the one which I'm using here. So when you install .NET framework, these are all, so this system.dll is the one which comes with .NET framework. So that is having your method, that is having your class, console class, which is having WriteLine method to print on it. So these are all, whatever you see here, all the DLLs or the files which you can refer, which comes with .NET framework. Okay, so there are so many files. See here, I have so many DLLs. These are all reusable components which you can use for your programming, which comes with .NET framework. Okay, so all of you able to see the system.dll inside version 4.0 folder? Yeah, that's great. I see only one response. All of you able to see this system.dll inside your version 4.0? Okay. So these are all namespaces, system.drawing. So imagine you want to do some drawings. So you have to
H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys, how we are different from our competitors. 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, Cloud Test Lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus, one-time fee and lifetime access to classes, access to recorded sessions of live classes. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For a free demo class, visit us at h2kinfosys.com.